It's always a good idea to set up a guest Wi-Fi password because it prevents users from accessing your main Wi-Fi account. This is especially important if you run an Airbnb, rental housing, or just for temporary visitors. And in this video, I'll show you step-by-step how to set this up. I'm on Ziply Fiber, but the steps are similar with Frontier, Verizon FIOS, and pretty much any other internet service provider. First, make sure you're already connected to your router via Ethernet cable or Wi-Fi. Then, find the information label on the router. Look where it says Advanced Device Configuration, and yours might be titled a bit differently. Here, locate the router's address. Mine is 192.168.254.254. And on some routers, they'll have something that looks like a web URL instead of numbers. Then, below that, take note of the device access code, which is the admin password of the router itself. But do understand that this is not the same as the Wi-Fi password. Now, open any web browser and type in the router address. Then, hit enter. I'm now on the router's status page. From here, click where it says Wireless Setup or something similar if you're not on Ziply. Here, enter the admin password we saw earlier. Now click on Guest Access 2.4 GHz. Here on the wireless configuration page, I first have to activate the guest account by clicking Enable. My router's default network name is Guest 6768, but I can change it to something more interesting or memorable. However, renaming this is optional. Then, in the Security drop-down menu, make sure this is set to WPA PSK. From here, I can use the pre-assigned password or type in something that's easier to remember. And it doesn't have to be all numbers. Then click Apply. On this page, click Continue to save the new settings. Now I can confirm that my guest Wi-Fi for the 2.4 GHz network is active. But since I have a dual band router, I can also set up guest access for the faster 5G network too. Just click on Guest Access 5 GHz on the main configuration page. And like before, I will enable this for guests. And I'll rename this network, but changing it is optional. No matter what though, keep the 5G at the end of the name so it's easy to distinguish this from the 2.4 GHz network. Make sure security is set to WPA PSK and you can keep the assigned password or create a new one. To make things easy, I'm going to use the same password as on the 2.4 GHz network. Now click Apply. Then click Continue. And now, guest Wi-Fi has been fully set up at my house. And from now on, it's a good idea to have all visitors connect to the guest Wi-Fi rather than your main network. And as you saw earlier, you can enable or disable it at any time. Or you can change the guest password without affecting connections on any devices currently using your main network. If this video was helpful, please give me a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all my weekly videos.